Is it true men are still trapped alive inside the Arizona?
We can hear tapping from inside the hull. We're doing everything we can to get to them, but they're 40 feet below water.
We've been trained to think that we're invincible. And now our proudest ship has been destroyed by an enemy we considered inferior. We're on the ropes, gentlemen. That's exactly why we have to strike back now.
We're preparing an attack against the Marshall and Gilbert Islands.
I'm talking about hitting the heart of Japan the way they have hit us.
Mr. President, Pearl Harbor caught us unawares because we didn't face facts. This isn't the time for ignoring them again. The Army Air Corps has long-range bombers, but no place to launch them. Midway is too far, and Russia won't allow us to launch a raid from there.
Admiral?
Navy's planes are small. They carry light loads and have a short range. We'd have to get them within a few hundred miles of Japan, and therefore risk our carriers. And if we lose our carriers, we'll have no shield against invasion.
Does anyone in this room think that victory is possible without facing danger? We are at war. Of course there's a risk.
But consider the risk, Mr. President. If the Japanese invade us right now, we'd penetrate as far as Chicago before we could stop it.
Gentlemen, most of you did not know me when I had the use of my leg. I was strong and proud, but arrogant. Now I wonder, every hour of my life, why God put me into this chair. But when I see defeat in the eyes of my countrymen, in your eyes right now, I start to think that maybe he brought me down for times like these when we all need to be reminded who we truly are, that we will not give up or give in.
Mr. President, with all respect, what you're asking can't be done.
Head back, George. Sit back. Do not tell me it can't be done.
Japan continues its military conquest throughout the Pacific. But back home, millions of American workers band together, bringing factories to life to avenge Pearl Harbor.
Mr. President, I think we have an idea about how to bomb the Japanese.
Sir, this
it's
is
risky,
a journey,
but it's bold.
Now
who are you?
Hi, sir.
Well, dance
Captain Lowe, Mr. President.
And you're there.
He's a submariner. He came up with this idea, for dance
music. I like sub-commanders.
This, then,
I don't have time for bullfighting, neither do I.
Sound
fire away.
In space.
He's the boogie-woogie bugle for the company bee. He was a